Hello everyone, it's Barry here. Welcome to my Virgin Kitchen. Hope you're well. Today is another food gadget review video. If you've missed any others, there's a playlist with a link up here and down below. But today's a bit different because it's one food gadget. This is a Destepabanana, which sounds like a bit of a rapper. Here come the Destepabanana. It's a bit weird looking thing, but basically with this, you can hollow out a banana and put in a filling of your choice. The banana of a thousand flavors is how they've marketed it. Massive shout out to my friend Paul from New York, who actually managed to ship this over for me because I was struggling to get it here in England. That might change, but it looks like it's pretty, it's an Argentinian device, I believe, but it's also available in obviously America and Australia, but not quite here in the UK. And it does look like something that Austin Powers would be proud of, but we won't get any further with that. You probably understand that reference. It's got a nice little filling tube too. We turn it over. Loads of ideas what you can put in there. Hard stuff apparently, liquid stuff. So we're gonna do quite a mix of that. We've got a little diagram. We've got the base, the banana holder, the head, what's that say? Stainless steel core and banana center removal slide. I'm trying to read upside down, but there we go. Looks pretty darn cool indeed. I'm a little bit skeptical because obviously bananas are curved. So we'll have a go. We'll follow the instructions and see how we get on. Oh, and in case you haven't noticed, I'm wearing my Barshins t-shirt today. That is a joint channel I do every Friday with Stuart Ashen, and also a podcast too. So check it out if you haven't already. And I'm actually mulling over doing these gadget videos rather than loads once a month, maybe once a week, like a gadget of the week video, so you can really get a bit more out of it. So let me know down below what you think of that. Anyhow, let's get it open. Oh, wow. There it is. That's pretty good quality actually. And there's our tube that we can fill any flavorings in. Now normally I don't read the instructions, but I think I will today. I'm gonna have a little glance at these, but we'll cut to that. I've been looking at the instructions now for a good 5 minutes, and even though they're in English and there's diagrams, they're pretty good. I'm still not fully confident that I'm gonna do it right, but we'll do our best. And what I've realized is this base bit, it's pretty darn pointless. It's just more of a stand for it. In the middle here, we've got the red bit and the stainless steel coring thing. So that's gonna do the hard work. And then this, I was expecting it to be quite a flashy thing, I don't know. But all it is, it's kind of like banana tongs, okay? So it's got a curved bit here. And what we do is we take the banana, which is obviously very curved, and we put it in upside down with that black bit showing, and then the stenny bit at the end. Shove this in, like so, right into the top as much as we can. And that's sticking up, right? So all we do is we try and manipulate it. Ugh, there we go. And sort of grip it together and hold it in place. So we've got ourselves a straight banana. And then apparently we pierce the top with the metal bit. Yep, that did pierce. And then we make sure that this red bit in the middle is flush. Push it in. And then twist the banana right here. Just twist it down. There's a little bit of banana residue appearing on there, but okay, this is okay. It's working so far. It hasn't burst out the sides, which was my fear. I was imagining it was gonna be, oh, the skin has split there, but we'll carry on. There's no banana exploded. And we need to peel it anyway. And then apparently what we do, there is banana gunk on this, not confident. We put our thumb on the red thing. Oh my gosh, that was getting a lot lighter as I was pulling it out. It looks like we've cored it, and then in here, it's like a banana cheese string. Amazing. So let's see if this is work. Obviously we can now embrace the fact that it's all curved. That's fine, it can relax again. There is a hole in there. So we can now add our fillings of choice. One of my personal favorite fillings, which I'm sure you guys will agree with, is some Nutella. I've just melted this up in the microwave and put it in the filling bottle. So we're gonna grab the hole like this. I'm still fascinated by that. That's pretty cool. We just push, I guess, syringe it in, like so. I'm gonna do it some bit of height so you can see it going in. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Show you, it is going in there. So I'm gonna go all the way until it reaches the top. Just giving it a little tap because as I've been filling it up, it's been going to the top and then air bubbles hitting the surface and it's been sinking down, reaching more filling. Just gonna make sure that does look about full. So I think we're ready to try this. Just gonna peel it, I guess. Here we go. There we go then. So that banana is perfectly fine. It's got the chocolate sauce in the middle, and just like on the advert, if I break it off like so, ah, oh, chocolate in the middle. Let's have a little taste. That is amazing. Oh, I'm so excited. Well, I also wasn't watching what I was doing, and a lot of it spilled out on the counter, so eat it fast. So just to test the flexibility of this, I've called out another two bananas which are here. One of them, I chopped up some chocolate cake and rammed it in there as much as I could, got it right to the top. It's actually quite weighty. And this one has actually got some chocolate matchmaker chocolates in it. They're basically firm chocolate sticks you can get here in the UK. You can also use like those coffee wafer ones that you get. That recommends that on the box. So let's try these out. This one is the one with the sticks of chocolate in. So you're gonna get like a nice, I guess, crunchy, snappy vibe going on. There you go. Oh, it's already broken for me, but there we go. I was expecting a snap, but it was like, yeah, I like this thing too. So that's in there like so. And this one, I'm sure I read somewhere that that end is actually the official way to peel a banana, but I always use the other end. I don't know, let me know down below. But anyhow, this is the one filled with cake right to the brim like so. We'll break it in half. Look at that. A banana, looks like eyes. Hello. Amazing. Prank your friends, put tomato sauce in one of these, and I guarantee they'll never talk to you again. There we have it then, folks. So the Destepabanana, really, really impressed with this. Let me know down below any other food gadgets you've seen. And if you like the idea of me doing like a food gadget of the week, something like that on the channel, let me know, or I can bunch them all together. Whatever you want to see, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Follow me on social media, and I'll see you again next time.